So we just put the old forks back in here for the time being. We're just going to run low, just have them in here just so they don't get lost and everything's together. Took my gasket off here and put it on that one. I don't have any extra gaskets to put in here like I thought I did, but shouldn't really matter for right now. Anyway, this one is probably not gonna be apart that long. Anyway. Gotta order an input shaft and wait for that to come in, and then we'll put a brand new input shaft in this tranny and then put it back in here again. But for, I don't know how long that's gonna be right this minute. I would rather get all these cover bolts back in here real quick. Washer for that one because the washer broke. So, for now, we're just gonna scoop this one back this way, like this. Since everything's all scratched to shit anyway, we're just gonna scoot that one over there. And we're gonna scoot this one over here. And I already put cover back on that one, put the gasket. This is the best cover that I have right now. The best nubs right here for the shift linkages. And this one has a pretty good reverse nub too. It's a little boogered up, but not too bad. It does have one chinger in the side right here, which looks like it came loose or something while it was being driven. But might have to replace that piece when we rebuild this transmission. But right now, let's try to clean her up. Spray her with a little paint. Guess I'm gonna make this one red too now, I guess. Since this one's always been black and that one's been red, but have to keep this one in there for a while, or rather it was red. Because it's easier to see leakage of the fluids than black. You can't really see whether things are leaking or not very well. So, I'm going to clean this up a little bit more here. Okay. We're going to set this over here for the moment. Okay, now we'll let that dry for a few minutes. We'll flip it over on here. touch up the other side real quick, and then we'll get ready to put it in.